This is so dope. I'm bouldering on the beach right now, and Chris is out there surfing. There's like people here chilling on the beach by these big logs, having like a campfire, man. I think this is like Northern Cali at its best.
Mercenaries of militants, no resemblance to any other assembly's heritage. Despair will be the downfall of arrogance. Repairs will be necessary. Too much heavy damage, counterintelligence. Spycraft flies past keys, the aviator. Resuscitation, reincarnation, I'm the reanimator. Greater mind power than Einstein. Genius and insanity, we walk in that fine line. Talk about prime time exposure. Face remains poker, overload the road to stardom like exploding supernovas. Maintain composure, low visibility, violent turbulence. You hear the voice of a surgeon and wake up in an ambulance. You're out of your element. A graveyard of skeletons, elephants in a caravan. Cross the mountain like Hannibal. Light the firing wicks, make the air thick with cannonballs. Nothing that I can't resolve, chemicals meant to dissolve.
Greed, pain, and torture. Locked inside my room, I'm an insane sorcerer. What I'm saying, Shane's forceful. You don't wanna fuck with a vein, can't cause so. War masked on a chosen path. You don't wanna laugh at the sociopath. Don't try to act hardcore, just stay soft. An unchained tip will rip your face off. Backpack with an axe and a chainsaw. Match out back, I'ma grab what I came for. Mass bandit, skin been branded. Smoke clears, I'm the last man standing. God bless me with a gift, I'm so grateful. Bent out of shape, but I still stay faithful. Purify poison, strength the gorilla. Mentally killer, meant to be iller.
Brian said, let's do a movie. I said, cool, man, where at? And he's like, I don't know. So I thought for a second, and I thought of NorCal. I was a little worried, honestly. I didn't think it was gonna be like the prime time to go up and go climbing in Northern California. Got boulders on the beach, got killer limestone inland, and you could do some surfing, you know? In the end, I was down, you know? I was psyched. It all seemed like it would just be dynamite.
Beach is pretty different than a lot of other areas. It's just the fact that the ocean is right there and it's so powerful and such an obvious presence that you can't really get away from.
So this trip for me is mostly revolving around just kind of like taking it easy. I'm not trying to go climb the hardest things I'm going, you know, I can see. I'm just kind of going to these areas and, you know, climbing what looks nice. It's a good place for taking it easy because it's beautiful and the vibe here is just mellow. And right now, I'm just kind of kicking it, man.
It's just nice to climb on the rocks on the beach because it's so free. There's no names, there's no grades. It's just you, the rock, the sand, the ocean, the air, the mist, the clouds, just climbing. Thank you.
setting is what's most kind of overwhelming about the place. And the ocean, like, is undeniably always powerful. And climbing next to it, it's just kind of a treat. This is just really, I don't know, just a powerful thing.
Him. Healthy for you.
That's what you need after a day of climbing.
Not no boulder diet, word.
The coolest thing about the Trinity Arets is that it's got tufas.
I'd say it's a little piece of heaven.
Every piece of the rock is blue everywhere.
You're talking about tufas, you're talking about like sharp, fresh blue limestone.
It's just like a little piece of a really nice cliff band, and it was like my dream climbing style. I like to push myself on steeper, harder stuff, but I don't think I'm naturally gifted at that, and I think I probably do a little bit better on more technical face climbing, and I really like kind of being scared and being above a bolt and like being exposed and having the wind go by. And oh, baby, that's all I got. Here to have fun, and I'm so psyched to climb with all these people, and it's just nice to be able to like share it with Luke. He's like a total inspiration to me, and he takes it with a grain of salt. He doesn't take this stuff too seriously. He just loves to climb and he loves to go to new areas.
There's this crazy dino route that follows up a 13B for a bunch of bolts and then cuts straight right, and it's very dramatic. Check you one time, what's the deal? Maybe I'm caught up in the thing that you know I like. I'll check it one time, baby.
Gomez, dude, just started chucking on the dino route. It's called spliff, the route. And Gomez got up there, just started hucking for it. And he actually like tore his hand up a little bit.
Your all points off pretty much, and you just swing all around when you grab it. It's crazy.
Thank you.
gotta know why. Oh, baby, that's
everywhere you go with climbing, there's spray. You know, I love climbing, that's my life. It's what I like to talk about, it's what I like to watch, it's what I like to read, it's what I like to see in photos. I'm a sucker for that stuff.
One love, yo. What it is, what it is. You don't stop. Is make money or just take money. A rat race, everyone for themselves. You only want the cheese when it's hard to pronounce. You want snakeskin slippers. You want money green couch. The snakes see you slipping, then they slip into your house. Cause everybody wanna be the next known thug. Sipping on something. King James had a bottle of. You out of sight, then you out of touch. You out your mind, alright. You out of money, then you out of luck. You out of pocket, then you out of love. Help, you fell balling, then you can't get up. You all
my hands in euros and Swiss notes. Call Lamborghinis and new Range Rovers. All the diamonds and the platinum trends. White sneakers to the Kangol lids. Get in the way and you will get dropped. Come around here, they will get dropped. Big diamonds and white gold shops. Long sneakers to the rims we got.
My song's time machines with Louis Vuitton seats. Polo with planets, guess your dreams. That's the brother that used to have a goatee, yeah. Verse worth more than Versace last name. I play stamps like YSL, that's why I sell.
Yeah.
My style, exact science.
Ow.
It's way too hot to climb it in the summer, in the middle of the day. So, you climb in the morning, you leave, you maybe go to the store, get some beer, get some lunch, whatever, head down to the river.
We call it the lazy river.
Right? We were just flowing down the river.
It's just pretty chill and you can like literally just lay in it and float down and...
I'm not a very good swimmer, so I was a little freaked out, man, but it was the best middle of the day activity I could think of. Go swimming, and then come back to the cliff later and feel refreshed and psyched.
Ah! Trinity of Rats isn't a big area by any means. There's only a few routes there, but the ones that are there are of complete quality. I noticed the proudest bolted line there when I showed up, and I asked locals about it, and I learned that it was an open project by the going name of Mean Streak. Follows this blunt arete of this perfect little tufa. So I applied myself, and a few days later, I red pointed one of the coolest routes I've ever done in my whole life.
Now he's got those stars in his eyes, pulled down from the midnight sky, and it ain't gonna be like you thought it was, but it could be like you're making now. Should I please take a step back from me? What the hell do you come all the way down to be? I know you don't see it, but I do, so keep on moving and I'll walk with you. You and I, now how hard do I have to try to find somebody like me, that the more like me, cause I feel like giving up, we can zip quite across the sky. You and I, now how hard do I have to try to find somebody like me, that the more like me, cause I feel like giving up.
Joe is like a great person to climb with. It's amazing how he's always motivated and he's always really psyched. I always try to really strive to find where that energy comes from.
If someone were to ask me about my background, I would have to say that with climbing, my background ethics come a lot from New Hampshire people. They're very much hardcore, diehard go-getters, you know, and I consider myself pretty much a go-getter because I like to make things happen, and I feel like a lot of my ethic has come from these guys in the Northeast, so I have a lot of pride in that.
He has really has a blind confidence about things sometimes. Like, he just approaches climbing and a lot of things in life like, hey, I can do this if I try really hard. And it's not that he's just naturally like all that great at everything he does. He just really, really tries and really like keeps that high energy about trying and doesn't get down and like, oh, this sucks. He really just stays positive, and I think that's awesome.
I was looking around the wall, searching for other, you know, open projects, and there was this one that cut right off these anchors of the 13A, and it was only 3 bolts, but it just looked micro edges on this just perfect kind of blue-gray limestone face, just slightly overhanging. I went up and started looking at it, and I don't know, I just like couldn't find the holds, but they were there. Like, I saw one there and I saw one over there, and it took me a long time to unlock the sequence. Doing it wasn't quite as bad as figuring it out. Like, I don't know, it boggled my mind for a while how I could possibly conceive of doing the moves. So it was cool that I think it was harder to figure out than it was to do.
Talk all night, do whatever you like, do whatever.
us out so we can talk some more.
Today we are in Northern California, bouldering on the beach. This part of the country in Northern California has lots of contrasting landscapes. Like right now we're on the beach and it's really humid. It's kind of just raining in the air right now.
I don't know if you can see in the air, but there's this constant mist and spray everywhere.
It's good to see that you can find beaches in the United States that are as clean as this and uninhabited. There's no houses anywhere and hardly anyone here, even on the weekend.
It's really inspiring, and there's no one here. It's just like a bunch of seagulls. One of my favorite things about being here is that I can just kind of leave the group and go and search around and find a rad problem that's like by itself.
Waves are pretty powerful, so definitely want to try to climb like a wave, like crash onto the rock and climb it hard.
Nice one, man.
Good job.
like a flag on top of the moon. Precious one, you have abandoned me.
Like when I'm climbing near the waves, there's always this roar of waves crashing, and it's this momentum that's always being carried through the air and through the water, and there's always energy hitting the coastline, and you're right there, right next to it.
There is almost nothing in between. Now I'm left like a flag on top of the moon. Precious one, you have abandoned me.
Background in climbing started 20 years ago now, and I'm 23. My parents started climbing when they got married, and they had me, and then I just started climbing pretty much straight from birth. You know, I was going to the cliff, and by the time I was about 3 years old, I was actually like climbing, like doing like 5'10s, and you know, I grew up trad climbing because trad was big in the 80s back when I started, And then eventually my dad broke his back, tried climbing in Indian Creek. I watched him, like two pieces popped and he hit the deck, bam! And we kind of stopped trad climbing so much after that and started sport climbing.
He's just kind of cruising up, man, checking out the route. Probably gotta brush some stuff. Yeah. Seldom climb route, you can tell, because it's zero chalk. Looking good. Little bits keep breaking off. Ooh. Oh my god. This is exciting itself, dude.
And now I like to call myself an adult. And I'm still climbing, and it's what I love to do.
Yeah. Come on, Chris. I'm psyched for Mickey's Beach.
Beautiful, man. This is like one of the coolest drives I've ever done.
So many boulders on this coastline, it's ridiculous. Littered with boulders and rocks out in the water, it'd be cool to like have a sailboat and just sail from San Francisco to Oregon and just explore. I think you'd find a lot.
We got to Mickey's Beach and my objective was to go to Surf Safari. We didn't toy around doing anything else, we just went directly to Surf Safari after like a 5-hour drive. Just walked right there, found the route, boom, nice steep wall.
I guess the first thing I think of when I think of Surf Safari, I think Chris Sharma, you know. And that was basically, in my mind, his birth to stardom in the climbing world, and he's been a star ever since.
When I was a young buck, I was probably 15 years old, and I read that Chris Sharma did, you know, 14-year-old does 514. That to me was like a huge deal.
To have a 14-year-old kid come along and do it was pretty amazing at the time.
And then that was so inspiring to me to just open that door and, you know, open your third eye and say like, man, it's possible for like us young kids to climb like really difficult routes.
It's a monumental route for sure.
I had to do the route.
Stranded on this island, myself needed solid ground, let the mash spark the flame like a pilot. See me on the silent, little Z better holler. Always pop my collar, roll like a Rottweiler. Diesel when we flex the slide in my Nexus. Yeah. Amp live, always represent Texas. I'ma get it hotter than the dance or chatter, chatter, chatter.
I had to do the route.
Flex like it's for sex, facts, that's your fizzle. While you get in jail, they be dappling your fizzle. I keep it solar, melt down your polar. You just a little baby cub on my sonar. I've been doing it and doing well, but you probably couldn't tell, cause I'm short on my mail. Make a break, 6AA, making a sale. What they told me at the label, but I rebelled. I'm like Nat Turner, carrying two black burners. My rap stacks attack like axe murders, and push further to the point, no return. Zion, I burn like a thick stick of sherm. You with this? You know the drill. It's like a non-massive on the rail. Did you like that? We gotta be. We end on up. Then we ride for you. Is you with this? You know the drill. It's like a non-massive on the rail. Did you like that? We gotta be. We end on up. Then we ride for you. Is you with this? Come on, little mama. 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 Yeah.
I'm like the cat working corporate but who never got a raise, who slaved in hell 1,000 days underpaid. Went to school to be a scholar, now I'm miseducated. But fuck what you know if you still can't make it. Seen a sister shake and break it to pay the monthly bills. Tuition, rent, survival skills is for real, but I'm stuck in this limbo. I speak to my kinfo, relate to the style, cause you overstand, you been broke. Seen a lot of suffering, seen a lot of woes, but where I finally go, only Mighty Jah knows. So I spent my lines, making minds hypnotized. I hope the gates of heaven open wide when I die. While you glimmer with glamour, I'll be stammering grammar. You like Arm and Hammer, I'm the funk Alabama. To bounce with the clout, bringing large amounts. Trust me, keep it dusty to turn shit out. Is you with this? You know the drill. It's like a massive on the rail. Did you like that? We gotta be. We end on it, then we rock for you. Is you with this? Come on, little mama. Is you with this? Come on, little mama. Is you with this? Come on, little mama. Is you with this? Come on, come on, come on.
I'm super psyched right now because this was like a route to me that really like changed, I guess, the potential for me to climb really hard. Seeing Chris Sharma in the magazines do this like years ago when he was 14. I was 15 years old, I read that, and I was just like, man, me and my buddies, we gotta up our game. I'm really happy right now. This was a really good set, a really good day, and we're just kind of closing it off right now. The sun's just like immaculate. We're psyched, man.
Spent a couple weeks of this trip in the Humboldt area, and then we decided to go down to the Mickey's Beach area to go try the surf safari route. And the whole time we were leaving, I just kind of had this itch that I kind of, you know, I wanted to come back up here. Like, I felt like there was something that I didn't do up here. I felt like there was something I wanted to do, and I couldn't really explain it. But I just had this real exploration bug. I heard about this place called Ossegon. It says it's Ossegon Rocks, so I'm kind of hoping there's rocks there. I think there's gonna be. But we just found out it's a 6 mile hike to the coast from where we're at. So. And we're gonna go for it, see what happens. Cross our fingers and hopefully come up big.
Rumors are right, we got more than this, but I see down the way some good boulders. I see actually a pretty cool face right here too.
Visions of how my path in life has turned into a powerful device of love and sacrifice. I never really had concise thoughts about the afterlife. How will my chosen path suffice if life is half as nice? You see, ideas come a dime a dozen, stuck inside a pizza oven. Think I tamed the beast that doesn't know but just one piece of love. And now I'm gonna teach. I know that words are valuable. It's how I'm gonna prove the biggest stains I'm water soluble. Cause each and all of you and me are just the soul's embodiment. So I try to be modest and never faulty or fraudulent. And I would never project with some inconjugate bullshit that's actually the opposite of everything I'm cool with. Short-tempered cause a fool's wit makes me intolerant. And this dream's a crazy drive, I hope my life can follow it. I still don't understand it, but I'll just take it for granted that I've been put on this planet to serve a purpose, a reason, a service to certain beings. Like every person hurt and bleeding in a fervent search for feeding my soul with a deeper meaning. And I'm breathing, but breath can be deceiving, believing that every next preceding day is just yesterday but repeating. Now I'm feeling all the guilt from certain dealings I dealt. But I never need any wealth the way I need mental health. So I put my demons on a shelf and start redeeming myself in hopes to rectify some truly evil feelings I felt.
Been trying to explore new places this year a lot. Know, try to go to obscure areas, try to find rocks that nobody's ever seen or seldom seen that are really cool, and you end up walking a lot and searching and searching and searching, and sometimes you find some cool stuff and most of the time you don't. I think you know, what we found today was fun. Got to play around on some rocks next to the beach, and it was a great day. It's fun, and that's what it's about. But the search continues.
In my lifestyle, we get to move around a lot. In this trip, there came the time when we had to, you know, go elsewhere. See, I love the beach, it's amazing, but I was tired of smelling like salt, I was tired of smelling fish, I was tired of like fish and chips for dinner every night. I was ready for some mountains.
Summer crack. We've gotta find out where we're going next.
So, Donner Summit.
I'm all dressed up and ready to play.
Voila.
I don't think these areas are Waco or other big areas that maybe have become, you know, overpopulated or anything. I think these are kind of smaller, kind of novelty areas that if you're coming through this area and you want to check out something different and something, you know, really cool and unique, like you would come and hang out for a weekend.
Coolest things about Donner Summit is like the Sierra California mountain rock. This granite is like some of the hardest, most like solid stuff I've ever grabbed. And I come from granite, man. I'm from New Hampshire, the granite state. Really technical. Technical from your fingertips to your toes.
And it's good for you, man. It's good to do these like routes that shouldn't be so hard for you with the grade, you know, but they make you do a different kind of action with your climbing, you know, and make you go, oh God, I do kind of suck on this. I thought I was good at this. No, I gotta like take a step back and like, you know, appreciate and be humbled and you know, just kind of learn again.
No letting your guard down on this stuff.
My goal for this area is to do the route called A Steep Climb Named Desire. Like, A Steep Climb Named Desire, when I first tried that route, it was honestly like, you know, felt pretty much impossible. I was just like, oh, good God, I'm probably gonna need like, you know, weeks to do this route. It just felt so hard. You just kind of like suck, and then you learn, and then you shrink down the learning part until just like executing parts, basically doing links, which is like, you know, the best thing. And then you get to the infamous one hang, which is, basically, you know, kind of a dumb term, I think, the one hang, but it's also the most important step before you do ascend, I think. For every route I've ever done that's been really hard, the one hang has been kind of like that line you cross over to the spot where you can say, okay, I'm gonna do it now.
I wanted to go do a steep climb named Desire because it's a hard granite route. You don't find a whole lot of hard granite routes. It's up in the mountains of California. It's an old school route, 14A, put up by Scott Fry, probably
the early 90s, so that makes it kind of cool to me just because it's like a really, really old route. The main pressure that I have is honestly my own pressure. You know, it's like I put pressure on myself to be a good climber, you know, because that's the most important thing to me, is to just like climb these challenging routes that I fall in love with. Honestly, it's not the most aesthetic route, but it's one of those routes that I was really eager to climb. You have this big wall with huge chains hanging off of it. Fixed gear and huge chain links, and not exactly pleasant to look at. But honestly, I just dismissed that, climbed the route only because it was a rad route. Chris and I are different in a lot of ways. But when it comes to climbing, man, it's just like the chemistry, it's on. It's on. There's good vibes there, man. Good vibes.
Show me a sign of the times. Is it corporate rule that uses organized labor as a torturous tool? Or is it how we landed here and disregarded sacred treaties and hunted wildlife until we had endangered species? You wanna wonder why schools are underfunded by a government that has enough bombers to overrun the sky? That's how we overtake the underprivileged overseas, just to understate the severity of our own disease. Yeah, I saw the beast that crushed your hopes and dreams and replaced your jobs with his cold machines. The same old police still roam the streets, the same hand that feeds you still holds your leash.
Yeah, Joe, dude, that dude's awesome. I've known Joe for like, I don't know how long. I remember like, I don't know, 10 years ago, we were at like Charleston, and like he had just gotten out of high school, and guy was probably like 14 or 15. We were sitting in the campground, lighting our farts on fire with the matches and stuff, having a good old time. More trouble than a teenage prank, let me be frank. It's nothing but a pissing contest. They brought in the bombs, and nothing was accomplished, but the damage was detrimental. They brought in new bloods, but the vets are always special. Nothing but train dates taught to mud wrestle. Special ops turning to blood spots and scud speckles. They're sending lines of troops, platoons of large vessels. Killing by the hundreds for heart stars and medals. A small reward for losing limbs to shards of metal. Spending time with their families. I was stoked to have Joe on this trip. I mean, I like that guy.
Now a kid is on the street with lots and lots of drugs to peddle. He's pissed as that he's dead, so he acts like he's a rebel. And his mother can't control him because her words are very gentle. They're going mental.
He's psyched, man. He's always psyched.
just as daddy's stencil. Probably hold a rifle or he holds a pencil.
Drastic measures for the treasure that you dig, digging for.
We should be at the lake because it's really hot. There's no clouds. The shade is minimal, especially this time of the day. It's just getting beamed on.
Sun's everything. High.
This is the shade. This is all there is in the whole place. It's
3.5 feet.
So.
Yeah, I mean, we should be like big pimping like Jay-Z on a boat.
Yeah.
On a boat with tubes.
And pina coladas.
Pina coladas.
And swimsuits.
Oh, hell yeah.
And jet skis.
Oh, man.
But instead, we're gonna try to climb because we love climbing even when it's hot. It's
still fun. I'm psyched.
After college, I moved to Boulder, Colorado. To support my climbing habit, I worked like lots of jobs. You know, a lot of like carpentry work that really wears your body out. And you know, just recently I've been able to be supporting myself through climbing, through my sponsorship. I'm living my dream right now. I'm one of those people that can say I'm living my dream.
Y'all ready? Serious on for a minute. Check it out. For the next few songs, you're gonna see a real part of me. And it ain't gonna be no comedy. I'ma tell you why these kids try and follow me. And why there ain't been another MC who's able to body me. It's what's inside of me. I'm the embodiment of doing what I love to do. And combining it the two. Rhyming and climbing too. But some of you, you had the audacity to diss. Now I'm on your iPod playlist, your favorites. I make this look easier than 5-6 surprise. It's another stroke of genius. Stuck in your head just like a crux sequence. Can you believe this? You thought it was corny, but now I see you checking the internet.
Right now we're in Donner State Park. This is our campground. We slept at last night for a hefty fee of $25. And this is about, I don't know, 300 feet from where we just camped last night. We got these rad boulders. Wake up. I haven't even brushed my teeth yet. Morning sesh. In the sun. It's all dry and nice out. Cool boulder.
I'm here to stay. You have no choice. This won't be the last time you hear my voice. Like friends and hang-dogging, changing ethics. You just gonna have to accept it.
Yes, it's true, I was always strong off of the couch until my skill didn't match my mouth. I had to wake up, shake up my routine, and take up sport climbing. I'm trying to be stronger.
Basically, my job description is to rock climb and to be a good ambassador to the climbing community. I feel peace and happiness with where I'm at in life, just being a rock climber.
Truthfully, that's me doing you a favor. Cause going against me will put your ego in danger. Yeah, it's as simple as that, just face the facts. I'm back and you hope that I'd fade to black. But make way, man, you should clear the tracks. I'm clipping bolts and boulder and it's not just cracks now.
Yeah, I'm here to stay, you have no choice. This won't be the last time you hear my voice. Like bolts in the 80s, changing ethics. You just gonna have to accept it. I'm here to stay, you have no choice. This won't be the last time you hear my voice, like friends and hang dogging. Changing ethics, you're just gonna have to accept it. Left foot's in the forest, right in the urban jungle. Tratty at heart, damn right I'm rough and tumble. But I'm an MC, it's hard to be humble. You can watch for a week and won't witness me crumble. Never stumble, technique impeccable. And you've seen my girl, so you know that she's incredible. Fun of things, she been leading 12 months. And already on site and route, you can't touch.
Being by the ocean has really been a big part of my life. You get yourself out of society and into a completely different world. And there's just nothing between you and Hawaii. And it's just an amazing feeling. And you know, you're just kind of part of a bigger thing. And it makes your small problems kind of go away.
You cannot ignore the ocean. Its size, its mass, its noise, everything, its activity is just completely undeniably powerful. And it's just like such an experience, you know, going to this place, and it makes you feel really small as a person. It's a potent place, and it's got that rewarding kind of feeling.
Couldn't explain it, but I had a gut instinct that told me that I needed to go search for something else. I felt like Humboldt wasn't finished. And I couldn't explain it to myself, couldn't explain it to the others. I just had that instinct and I had to follow it. So I drove back up north and started searching the coastline. I just wanted to do something new. Eventually I found what I was looking for and ended up being this prow, and it's just this beautiful prow. It's like you can look at it from north on the beach, you can look at it from south on the beach, it's just beautiful. Boom, right overlooks the ocean. Waves are crashing at the foot of it. I mean, it's just brilliant. Down on the side that I wanted to climb, which is like the steeper side that overlooks the ocean. Figured it out where I wanted the bolts, drilled it in, and put in some removable bolts and tried it with those. After I'm done, I'll take them out. It solves two purposes. A, bolts don't get rusty, and two, you leave a pretty low impact on the area because it's just holes in the rock and there's no metal, shiny stuff. We'll be right back.
Being in a place like this, being so primitive and pristine, it just reminds me of how important it really is to maintain and take care of your areas and just really be respectful of where you're climbing.
So it's really everyone's responsibility to just maintain that positive image that we as climbers are respectful of nature. We don't like to litter, and we like to pick up after others. And we love this land, and we love the rocks that we're allowed to climb on, and we appreciate that we are allowed to climb on them. And we give money to the Access Fund to ensure that we can climb on them. And just be respectful as every climber should be, and usually every climber is.
I've been searching all around for something that I put down.